Hey, my name is Ryan Morgan.
My name is Aaron Morgan. We're from Seabird. And we are recording our second album. For this album, I think we wanted to kind of mature, both musically and lyrically. You know, we're obviously getting older. Not that we're old men or anything, but have families now and just experiencing different, you know, aspects of life. And we think that our audience has kind of matured with this as well. The first six songs of the record were tracked in Nashville at the Smokestack, which is run by producer Paul Moak. Paul really created a really great working environment and a very creative, free-flowing environment for us to work in.
Just the two brothers in general, their dynamic and the way they interact with each other. I've never made a record with two brothers like that. I think the strongest characteristics that really make me gravitate towards the music is Aaron's writing style and the sheer power of his voice. It's very convicting. He's just got a special talent. I'll make you shiver when I
turn rocks into rivers like more. Time in LA has been fantastic. The studio here at Ocean is amazing. We've never really tracked in such a big studio and such a big room, you know. So the sounds that we're getting are fantastic. And, you know, Matt Hale's producing these four songs is kind of a dream come true for me. I've been a huge Aqualung fan. This whole week has been really great, you know, having one of our favorite artists give input and direction to our songs.
I really like Aaron's voice, and I like there's something kind of direct about his songwriting, but it's also always got a little twist and turn, which I always really appreciate. He's got a knack for sort of doing something simple in an interesting way, and I mean that as a compliment.
Paul and Matt both have their different takes on our music, but the awesome thing is that they both understood our music so well that everything that they did contributed to our songs, to our arrangements and everything.
Songwriting process for us typically begins with a piano, finding something great or something really terrible, you know, speaking specifically of the instrument, something that's really inspiring or that kind of evokes a certain emotion for me is where it starts. But we want to continue making songs that inspire people to change or to grow or to find, you know, something that they really love, you know, whether it be an art or a person, whatever. So I definitely think that there's a musical progression in these songs, but at the same time, you know, definitely some rock sensibility to the songs here.
There really is a message of hope, you know, in the record, and lyrically, but also musically.
The song, Don't You Know You're Beautiful, is about a girl who carries the weight of her parents' divorce on her own shoulders, believing for years, like many kids do, that it's somehow her fault or her responsibility to fix it. But she comes to know the truth about herself, that she is a beautiful creation set apart for bigger things. Recording this record has been a completely different experience from the first one, and it's one that's completely rebuilt our confidence as a band. At the same time, I think it's going to allow the younger listeners or maybe the old fans that we already have kind of grow with us musically.